Hi, I'm Ashwant. Welcome to the Interview Mantra playlist. Today we have a special guest. So she is Gnana Tejaswini Awala. She is currently working as a member technical at CDK Global Hyderabad. So it is also a product-based company. So today she is going to share her views on interview experiences and her journey in her career so far. So Tejaswini, welcome to the Interview Mantra playlist. First of all, thank you for accepting my invitation to be a part of this. And how are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing good. Thank you, Ashwant. So firstly, I'd like to thank you because thank you for having me on your channel. Yeah, I'm doing good.
Yeah. So yeah, I just gave a brief introduction. Can you please share about yourself, your role and your experience so far? I mean, just your designation and your company.
Sure. So as Ashwant said, I have been working with CDK Global for 1.5 year or so. Ashwant was my colleague and he recently moved to some other company. And coming to my role, I am a developer, mostly do backend related stuff. And in recent times, I started working on frontend related work also. So the technologies that I work on or Java, Spring, and then Spring is framework, and then React. So what we do in CDK Global?
Yeah.
CDK Global develop products that help dealers to sell their cars to the customers. So we develop all the softwares that are required for the dealer. So for example, if any customer comes to the dealership, and so for the car servicing, then dealer can book a particular slot for the customer and assign employee to that slot so that that request will be taken care of. So dealer can do that from our software. So apart from that, we can take care of stuff like payment processing, maintaining vehicle inventory, and then we take care of sales and we generate reports based on records on our systems and a lot more. So that's brief about my company and role.
Yeah, I think it covers almost everything about CDK Global. Then how did you get selected for CDK? I mean, I'm starting from your online test or entrance test to joining in the CDK, can you share that journey? How did you get selected for?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
So totally, I gave 8 interviews and selected for 4 companies. But basically, there were not many companies coming to our college. So, and the offers that I got from the college are not of my interest. So some of them are having some agreements like I should work for that company for 3 years.
Okay.
And some of them, I don't like the roles or so. So I decided to go with off-campus. So I got to know about CDK Global is recruiting through my friends. So I went through company profile and the role. I liked it. So I applied it online. And my first round was written test. I was... So that went on online. I was given some programming questions and then some MCQs and that covers all most of the subject basics like aptitude, data structures and algorithms, computer networks, operating systems, likewise.
Okay.
That covers all the basics and all. I got shortlisted for the first round and gave interview in Hyderabad. Interview consists of 3 rounds, 2 technical rounds, and then 1 HR round.
Okay.
That's all.
And how your interviews went on, is it moderate or did you feel any difficulty in clearing those interviews?
So coming to CDK Global interview process, I didn't feel any difficulty because CDK Global was my last interview that I gave.
Okay.
Before that, I gave almost 7 interviews. So I'm very much confident with what I know.
Okay.
So I didn't feel much difficulty.
So that experience really helped you in clearing CDK interview, right? Your past interviews.
Even I didn't select for my past interviews. Helped me a lot on how I present myself, how I respond to their questions and all.
Yep. It was really a good thing to note from your point, because if we attempt for multiple interviews and multiple placements, so even though we fail in all those things, but the experience that we get, I mean, talking to technical people, talking to HRs, so we get vast amount of experience and we can use that to clear at least one interview in the end. So instead of sitting idle, or fearing that we don't know anything. So if we go past and attend all those interview stuff, so I think that will really help people. Okay, good to hear.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So other thing, what are the resources that you follow regularly to stay updated? I mean, during your college times or preparing for interviews, whatever it is.
So the resources I follow just YouTube. I just subscribe to some of the YouTube channels which post about recent technologies regularly. When I was in college, I used to follow some YouTube channels and know the updates, and that's pretty much about that. Sometimes I Google it about some things. That's all.
Okay, good. So CDK Global, like you are working in CDK Global, it is a product-based company, right? So what do you think the real difference between a service-based company and a product-based company? Is it the work that really matters or any other thing?
So I don't know much about service-based companies, but as far as I heard from my friends, so in a product-based companies, mostly the candidates that got recruited will get some work, but in most of the service-based companies, some of the candidates will get work projects, and some of the candidates won't get work. Coming to work, it's all depends on in which project we get into.
Okay.
So even if it is service based and or product based.
Okay. Okay. So if one need to select for a product based company, so what do you think the strategy that one should lay off from the beginning?
So let's forget about interviews for a while. So before that, we need to ask ourselves one question that you entered one bus, graduation bus. So there are going to be many stops for that. Which city you want to go to? Startups, service-based companies, or product-based companies? And again, which village you want to go to? Full stack engineer, front-end developer, back-end developer, DevOps engineer, or UX designer? Just be aware that there are lot more streams in software industry, and decide which is your interest. Sometimes you really like the journey and you may want to travel further. That is post-graduation. You may go for M.Tech, MS, or MBA. First, decide where you want to go. So what I feel is, unless and until we have destination, we never know where to go. We don't have any idea why we are going. Why we are even traveling. So choose your favorite destination and take your steps in that direction. That is what I'd like to say. Okay. And if your choice is to get into a job right after graduation, then interview preparation. We should really focus on interview preparation.
Okay.
So if you want to go into a good company, this is really definitely not a 1 week process. We should take care of some basic things long term. So I would say there are two levels. So first level is for the students who are in second and third year of their graduation. So in first level, we should focus on, I would say, three things. So first is problem solving. Second is internships. And then third is you know, project work.
Okay.
So first, as I have already discussed, so we should really not focus on learning so many programming languages. They are just tools to communicate with mission. So basically, just ask yourself one question. Why do we write programs?
Okay.
So generally, there will be a problem statement. We just want to automate that process or, you know, reduce manual dependencies. For example, you may have given a problem statement like MCAT college allocation.
Okay.
So based on candidate marks and the colleges that candidate has selected, we have to allocate that student to appropriate college. So if the scenario is given to us, we first generally think in algorithmic approach, like, you know, if our problem statement involves sorting based on student marks. Yes. So which sorting algorithm best suits for, you know, for our for our scenario.
Okay.
And then and things like that. So this is called step by step process and get into solution. This is called problem solving technique. And once we are ready with all these steps, we just use programming languages to solve as a communication tool.
Yeah, it was just a carrier, right?
Yeah. So how one should improve their problem solving skills? So there are many sites available to improve our problem solving skills, competitive programming sites. Personally, I use CodeChef. You can browse for the competitive programming sites. So there are tons of lists coming on. And go and solve at least 3 to 4 problems per week and participate in their contests. So they will give us some ratings, which indicates our coding standards and then problem solving skills, you know. So which we can put it on our resumes, which uplifts our resume value.
Okay.
So one more advantage for this is these days many companies are giving, you know, programming questions in their first level of recruiting process itself. If we practice them daily, it will be very helpful. So it helped me a lot. That is all about problem solving. So internships. Why one should go for internships? So I would say by academics, we won't get some knowledge about some things like what are some industrial practices. You know, how projects evolve from requirement stage to client release process.
Okay.
So how teamwork is gonna like. So a lot more. You'll get good knowledge if you do internships. It's a good thing to mention on resume as well. So I'll share my experience. I got internship opportunity in third year of my BTech. But for some reasons, I didn't go.
Okay.
So when I joined CDK, Ashwant, you may know, 20 of us joined as freshers.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Some of us already did internships.
Yep.
What I felt is I'm a little behind than the guys who did internships. Internships are really good. They are much knowledgeable. So go with internships. And then third one, I would say, is projects. So by working on projects, we'll get hands-on experience and then we can showcase our work to recruiters. Projects plays really a key role in the recruitment process. And there are many. So if you are not from a reputed college, you don't know, you don't have much exposure. You don't know how to start the project. You don't have any ideas. So go with already implemented project. If you're stuck somewhere that already has the solution, so go refer to that. Complete that first and then start your new project. Later start your new project. And there are a lot many resources available on the internet on how to get started with projects. Make a repository on GitHub and upload all our work there. So So that's all about level one. So coming to level two, there is level two is a little light because we have already done groundwork on level one itself. So level one is when you are on fourth year. So there are three things I would say for level two. That is brush up, dress up, and attack. So brush up, what is brush up?
Interesting.
So simply just you just brushing your basics, focus on some important topics like data structures or algorithms or computer networks. Likewise, focus on main topics only, just brush up your basics. That's all. After that, if you want, you just go on Google it for interview questions for freshers or interview questions on Java. Likewise, it's up to you. So,
okay.
Basically, you just need to remember that they don't expect much from freshers. They don't stress on things. So, be cool. So, second one, brush up is done. Second one is dress up. So what I mean is you have to be very good at presenting your skills. So the first thing that comes up on presenting your skills is resume, nothing but. So resume goes into interview room first, then you go, right?
Yes.
And what I feel is that resume talks a lot with recruiter than you do. So our resumes should be simple and clear. Don't clutter with many things. So we should use technical terms because, recruiter is not going to spend much time on our resumes. Sometimes resumes will be filtered using some keywords Java, problem solving. So in those cases, if we want our resume to be there, we must use keywords, technical terms. So what I feel is as we are freshers, we generally don't have much work, to include in resumes. So our resumes must be single page. So what to mention in resume is just mention about your details, your personal details, phone number, email, and then academic details, and then any experiences. So if you take any internships or if you have done any freelancing projects, so you can mention that, and then projects. So by including all of them, projects and then experience, you should be able to answer the question that they are going to pose. At least you should answer 70%.
Yep.
So, because they want to test how much you understand on what you worked on.
Yes.
So it is very important. I feel so.
Also, then, like adding to your point, like I can also say that we can fix our interview, like how the interviewer will ask us. It depends on the resume. Like if we write only the things that we are well versed with, then interviewer will only ask the questions about that particular point.
Yeah, so we'll only it is in our hands. Topics.
Yeah, it is in our hands actually.
But I agree. So the last thing is updated profiles.
Yeah.
Profile means GitHub profiles, LinkedIn profiles, and then competitive programming profiles if we like CoreChef and all, if we have any. So that's all. Our details, our experiences, projects, and then our updated profiles. Simple and clear.
Yep. These were some.
We are done with dress up and brush up. So last thing is attack. So generally before we announce any battle, we should have a battlefield, right?
Yes.
So what I mean is we should have a first job opening position so that we can battle with our soldiers who come up with us to give interviews. So if we are from some colleges which doesn't get many offers from companies, what to do?
Yeah.
So go for off-campus selection. Trust me, it is not that hard because personally, I got offered in CDK through off-campus selection only, as I mentioned.
Yes.
So nowadays, what are the things we should consider to get off-campus offer? There are only simple things, only three things. First is, so nowadays many companies are outsourcing their hiring work.
Yes.
What I mean is, there
and
are
these platforms like AmCat and other.
Yes. Yes. There are other companies who help these companies to hire the candidates. For example, as Ashwanth mentioned, AmCat, and then say HackerRank or HackerEd, go to job section, and then there are many active contests available there. Apply for the contests,
yeah.
And then take exam based on your rank and your score. You may get interview call. So that's that simple. First thing is that, and then there are some website like AngelList, Navari.com, and then
even LinkedIn. Even LinkedIn is a source. Yeah.
So when you get registered on those websites, you'll get notified if there are any vacancies. Again, while registering to these website, your profile should be strong. Your profile should contain all the details what you have mentioned on the resume. Then only your profile will get shortlisted. And then, as Ashwanth mentioned, LinkedIn profile. There are many recruiters out there on LinkedIn. In case of some open position, they will post it there. Or else, if they really like your work, they will offer you for some particular. They will offer you jobs. Even for example, Ashwanth got his recent opportunity through LinkedIn only.
Yeah.
So it's very powerful, I would say. So last option is I'm saying this is last option because this have this problem. Probability of getting calls is very low because so go for company's website directly and go to career section. Search for the vacancies that opt for your profile. If there are any, apply.
Yep.
That's all.
I think the last point works. If there were startups, then the last point definitely works.
Yeah, yeah. Correct. So that is all for level two.
Okay.
It is simple to get off-campus jobs also.
Yep. These were some great insights, Ashwini. So glad like people get more knowledge. And also like I got to know some new terminologies like brush up and dress up, all those things. Yeah. So, I mean, did you face any challenges in the beginning of your journey with your first company? Because as it is a first company, like everyone is new to the environment, right? So everyone is new to the company environment,
yes.
Work environment. So what are the challenges that you faced in your early stages of your career?
So I'm basically not from the college, got much exposure. So
okay.
I don't know pretty much about the industry standards and all. So it takes me some time to get aligned with industry standards and how things work here, how the project goes and project flow and all. So it takes some time for me.
Okay.
So now, the thing is, when we are working, we have to figure out the things on daily basis. Daily some things will change, some new technologies will come. So we have to figure it out.
Okay. So we should be updated, with the trend, the first thing. Okay.
Correct.
That's good. And like, what do you think the most common mistake that college students do in their third year or final year or whatever it is? So what is a common mistake that most of the people do? I mean, if they say like, I failed to qualify for a company placement or whatever it is. So what do you think the most common mistake that many people will underestimate or fail to do?
So Right from my college days, I felt that most of the students focus much on learning so many programming languages instead of learning problem solving. So learning so I feel that programming languages are just tools that helps us to put our ideas to solve a problem. So there is no point in learning many programming languages.
True.
So instead of students should focus on problem solving.
Yep. So like I do get many questions, I mean, among my YouTube subscribers or many other people, like which programming languages to learn. But people don't really ask me like what is the main source to get a job, because the main source to get placed into a product based company or whatever the company is, because the main source is problem solving. Like if you are a good problem solver and if you know good idea on like data structures and algorithms, ultimately companies will hire you. But instead, like if we know 7 to 8 programming languages without having much detailed info about how data structures work and algorithms work, it is of no use, right?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's good actually. That differs a normal engineer and a product engineer, and you got that right way. So yeah, like apart from, I mean, this coding and other thing, like what do you do in your free time to, I mean, keep you relaxed?
Okay, I don't have so many habits. Sometimes I do exercises, sometimes I go and help in household works, and these days I'm spending much time on YouTube. So pretty much what comes into my mind, I do that.
Okay, fine. So one advice, like apart from programming and this problem solving, so what are the other things that people should be familiarized with? So while leaving the college, so yeah, people in generally, if people need a software job, the main thing they focus is programming. So it might be competitive coding or learning a programming language. So apart from programming, what else, what is the major skill that people need to know, I mean, while going out of the college and entering into a new company?
So they should keep in mind one thing while so many of us even have one myth on our minds that it is ending of learning, but even after leaving the college, every day is learning. We should be updated every day on daily basis. So but and then the second point is we should be, if we are trying for off-campus jobs, we might get tensed. Like there is so much competition for this. Do I really fit into this job? So be confident with what you know. So I personally faced the same thing for one interview. I was, so I was a bit tensed that day because that company is, you know, is offering pretty much a big big amount.
Okay.
So I am having doubt that whether I am really fit into this company and all. So I was not able to answer questions that I know in that interview. So after that, I decided that no one knows everything. Since we are freshers, they don't expect much from us. So if they ask anything, if we know the answer, we can tell them. If we don't know them, we can tell it with the confidence that we don't know that. They sometimes, they will even explain us the answer. What is the answer for that question? So that's all. We don't need to worry much about it.
Yep. See, one single sentence suggestion for all the viewers. Like if their aim is to get placed in a company like CDK Global, so what is the one thing, I mean, one thing that they need to focus on? So apart from all that we have discussed up till now, one suggestion.
So I'd say one suggestion is be confident because that's all matters in the interview. So if we are confident and calm on the interviews, then we can definitely give our best on interviews.
Okay.
So be calm and patient before the interview.
That's great. So yeah, I think the viewers got many points to note down, I think. So this will really change at least a few people's career. So, and again, like, thank you so much for accepting my invite and being a part of this video and helping others and motivating others with your I mean, inspirational quotes. So yeah, that's it for today. And there are many other sessions that were launching day by day. So please like this video again. And
so we have any thank word? You, Yashwant. Yeah, thank you, Yashwant, for sharing all the information you have with the people out there. Yeah. So I really appreciate your work. And please subscribe to Yashwant's channel because there are many insightful videos coming on the way. So stay tuned.
So my subscription note is covered by her. So yeah. So again, like I'm telling, like, please like and share this video. As she told, like, please subscribe to my channel and also let others know about this video by sharing this and spreading a word about this. So yeah, thanks again. Thank you for watching.